Hey YouTube, it's Chris Cornaris here with the Cryptocurrent team, bringing you another episode of Crypto Decrypted. Today we're continuing the discussion of ERC tokens with the ERC-777. So let's jump right on in.
Crypto Decrypted.
All right, now before we dive into the meat and potatoes of today's episode, I do want to remind y'all that if this is your first time coming to the channel, how about you go down below and hit that subscribe button? It really would help us out. And if you enjoyed today's content, of course, please don't forget to leave a like as well. Now, let's do a quick recap. So ERC tokens. ERC stands for Ethereum Request for Comment. And essentially, it is a document that has been approved by network members as a good template for new tokens. First, we discuss the ERC-20, which is the most popular token standard for blockchain projects and tokens released on the Ethereum blockchain, and it is called a fungible token standard. Essentially, what this means is that at any given time, a coin built on top of the Ethereum blockchain will have the same value as another of the same coin. Now, that may have been a little confusing. Essentially, it means that if you have two of the same token in a single project, and say one is worth $2, the other one or any other one you look at will always be worth $2. Last week, we covered the ERC-721, which is a non-fungible token standard. Y'all may recognize that. Remember it from NFT projects because NFT stands for non-fungible token. And essentially what a non-fungible token standard does is it allows for tokens within the same project to be listed at different prices. Doesn't mean as much for just a monetary token. It is really only important for projects where the token is tied to a different kind of asset, for example, digital art. Now, those were the ERC-20 and ERC-721s. Today, we're going to be discussing the ERC-777. The ERC-777 is a proposed format for ERC tokens. Right now, the way the ERC-20 works is that when you first initiate a transaction, that first transaction is going to kind of start up the smart contract the token is tied to. But it then requires a second transaction to essentially verify that the correct conditions for that contract are met. Now, what the ERC-777 is proposing to do is essentially do all of that in a single transaction, which would at the very least, hopefully cut in half the number of transactions on the Ethereum blockchain that involve ERC-20s, which would reduce a lot of the network load, reduce gas fees, transaction times, etc. Not to mention, there's a cool security feature. The ERC-777 will also allow users to blacklist certain addresses. For example, say there are addresses that are, randomly sending you things and you're worried they might be a scam. Well, you can blacklist those and essentially prevent yourself from ever receiving what is a scam token or something in the first place, which actually makes your wallet and your tokens more safe and secure without really changing anything that you do. But that actually is going to cover the bulk of the ERC-777. So let me just walk you back through what I just discussed. So the ERC-20 tokens are secure and they do work as intended. However, the ERC-777 is trying to improve on the ERC-20 by reducing the overall transaction overhead. And essentially in the long run, while the ERC-777 isn't currently implemented, it could be a great kind of improvement and successor to the ERC-20 without changing much. And I hope that was interesting and informative for y'all and that it made sense. If it didn't, of course, go down to the comment section below and feel free to ask me any questions as I do read all of the comments. But until next time, guys, I've been Chris Cornaros and I hope y'all are staying cryptocurrent.